This is ABC 7 News at 11, your Suncoast News. We're here for you.
Hello and welcome. I'm Scott Dennis. Thanks for joining us tonight. Haley has the evening off. We begin with North Carolina's bathroom bill. Lawmakers gathered for a special session to repeal that law. HB 2 limits LGBT rights, including which bathroom a transgendered person can use. Tonight, lawmakers failed to repeal it, creating even more controversy. ABC's Richard Cantu reports.
Today, the legislature had a chance to do the right thing for North Carolina, and they failed.
The special session is over, but North Carolina's bathroom bill still stands.
And I don't know if you think the public is stupid, or we're stupid, or who's stupid, but it just does not make sense.
The state's Democratic lawmakers frustrated and angry, accusing Republicans of a bait and switch, first proposing a bill that would repeal HB 2, but including a provision that would prevent local governments from passing anti-discrimination laws for at least 6 months.
It is not normal to waste 4 days to accomplish nothing.
We had a great opportunity, I think, to do some good work.
The so-called bathroom bill says people can only use the bathroom in public and government buildings that matches the sex listed on their birth certificate. Opponents call it discrimination against LGBT people. Supporters say it's about safety.
We don't have a discrimination problem in this state.
Most people just want to use the bathroom that they're comfortable with.
HB 2 cost North Carolina big business. PayPal pulled hundreds of jobs out of Charlotte. The NBA moved the upcoming All-Star game to Louisiana, and numerous musicians canceled concerts there.
I'm afraid the public consciousness outside of the state will hold us accountable.
The repeal vote was seen as a way for the state to reclaim its reputation, but ultimately, no compromise, no repeal.
I cannot believe this.
Richard Cantu, ABC News, New York.
In order to get lawmakers back to that session, the Charlotte City Council repealed its anti-discrimination ordinance, which was largely seen as the catalyst for HB 2. The council says it acted in good faith and will continue to work toward a solution. German authorities are offering more than $100,000 in reward money for information leading to the arrest of a Tunisian man. He's considered a suspect in Monday's Berlin Christmas market attack. A European arrest warrant says Anis Amri should be considered armed and dangerous. The document indicates the suspect has used 6 different aliases and claimed 3 different nationalities in the past. German authorities say they rejected the man's asylum request in July. Meanwhile, dozens of Christmas markets across Germany open today under heavy security.
Well, I think it's a good thing to just sort of get back on and do what we would have always done anyway and still remember those that lost their lives in such a tragic way.
In Berlin, city officials say 12 people are still being treated for very serious injuries. A dozen Christmas shoppers died in that attack. Now to Mexico, where a deadly explosion tore through a fireworks market. The death toll continues to rise, with at least 32 people now dead and more than 70 injured, including children. Still unclear how this happened, the explosion coming during the market's busiest week, just before Christmas and New Year's Eve. Overnight, the Red Cross moved in, rushing injured victims to hospitals, some with burns over 90% of their bodies.
There was a big cloud of smoke that started to disperse at night. But, you know, there's a lot of people crying, a lot of state police, firemen, the Mexican Red Cross arrived on the scene. And it really looks like a war zone. It reminded me of some of the images I've seen in Syria or Iraq.
3 children are coming to the United States for treatment at a hospital in Texas. Tonight is the winter solstice, meaning the year's longest night. The Salvation Army uses this night to memorialize the dozens of homeless people who died this year on the Suncoast. ABC 7's Ray Collins joins us now with details of a solemn vigil tonight in Sarasota. Ray?
Yes, got bagpipes, candles, and taps, an emotional event on this chilly winter night.
Russell Kennedy, age 51.
Captain Andy Bailey read the names of the 32 people known to have died homeless in 2016 in Sarasota.
Francis Orbick, 54.
The Salvation Army estimates another 25 died in the streets of Manatee County, and most of them were drug users.
Yes, absolutely. The vast majority of them are.
Salvation Army's Chris Johnson says there's only so much they can do for their clients.
We consistently reach out every week, every day, but it is ultimately the choice of the individual as to whether or not they take part in anything we have to offer.
Kedrick Bull, age 58.
Those left behind join hands and pray for the loved ones they lost this year.
Who have graduated to glory.
Some of those at this ceremony say there'd be even more names read if not for the Salvation Army.
There's no place for them to go out there.
If there wasn't the Salvation Army, they would be all in the street.
They'd all be in the streets, that's right.
Timothy and Paul wish the city and county of Sarasota could do more.
Because there are a lot of homeless still out there yet.
What more could be done, do you think?
I think a lot of people of the city council and the government should get together and have a program to help more of these people.
And they say more died this year than last year in the streets of the Suncoast. 57 this year, they say. Scott.
And Ray, the city and county working together at this point on the homeless issue in the region really just hasn't happened, has it?
No, the two sides have very different visions on the homeless and how to solve it. And there hasn't been a joint session now in over a year.
All right, Ray, thank you so much. As you heard, a chilly night for that ceremony tonight, but a nice one on the first night of winter, Bob.
Yeah, it's starting to feel a lot more like the season. In fact, today out in the waters, temperatures were in the 50s, and with the wind blowing and no sun, it was cool out there to say the least. 59 degrees right now. Dew point is at 56 degrees, and that's dropping. So we're going to see temperatures to wake up tomorrow morning into the mid-50s for the most part. Winds are out of the north-northeast, very light at 5 miles an hour. Now, some slightly drier air has moved in, so we may see some fog, but it's not going to be as thick as it was this morning, and it should burn off a little sooner. Right now, you can see some of that low-level cloudiness kind of working its way down toward our area, so that will be in place. This particular model suggesting a little bit more fog around right now, but that's not the case, so this may be a little overdone. We will see some fog form, though, later on, and then eventually that fog should be out of here pretty quickly. So today it took until almost 2 p.m. for it to get out. I think tomorrow a lot sooner and a lot more sunshine is in your forecast, and that means warmer temperatures. Well, the details and all that coming up in just a few minutes, Scott.
All right, thank you, Bob. New details tonight on what the Bradenton Police Department is calling a suspicious incident at an elementary school. Police say a minor lied about being approached by a man outside of Seabreeze Elementary School Tuesday. The child originally told officers that they were approached by the driver of a white car and asked if they wanted treats or goodies and asked for the child to get into the car. Police now say that incident never happened. Manatee County and the school district continue to push for funding to help make walking to and from school safer. The school district is looking to improve several areas throughout the county, including near Bayshore High School. County and school district want to add lighting on a long stretch of 53rd Avenue West and 34th Street West to make it safer for students.
Sometimes cars don't have their lights on and you can't see the cars either. So it's really dark. Can't see sidewalks, can't see the nothing. It's hard to ride.
I think it's a great idea. It's very dark at night and it is pretty dangerous with the way the cars drive up and down here very fast.
Manatee County Public Works Department and School District are hoping to receive money for these projects from the Safe Routes to School organization. Sarasota County is reporting a release of wastewater discovered around 6:30 Tuesday night. It happened at the corner of Wake Avenue and Rangy Drive, which is just a few blocks from Bee Ridge Road. About 10,000 gallons were discharged from a sewer line. The county is taking action to repair the pipeline and clear the area. The sewage reached the stormwater system, which is like ditches and things that lead to ponds, but the county says there is limited risk to public health. If you need to get your license renewed or rent a book from the library, you only have one day left to do so. Most Sarasota County government offices will be closed Friday and Monday for the Christmas holiday and January 2nd in honor of New Year's. County libraries will be closed Friday through Monday, and buses will not be running on Christmas or New Year's Day either. Good news for trash collection, though, there will be no changes to the collection schedule. Travelers across the country can expect an increase in traffic both in the air and on the ground this weekend. AAA predicting more Americans will travel this year's holiday season than ever before. The group believed more than 103 million Americans are expected to go somewhere. About 93 million of them will be driving, which is a 1.5% increase over last year. AAA study finds lower gas prices and increased consumer spending are both driving forces behind the increase. Straight ahead, Chief Meteorologist Bob Harrigan will be back with the official Suncoast forecast. Plus, why a measure allowing gun license holders to carry openly at more places is expected to breeze through the legislature this year. We'll tell you why. And the family of a gun violence victim is suing the location where their daughter was shot and killed. My Christina Grimmie's family is blaming the concert venue where she performed.
Sarasota Jungle Gardens invites your family to the Holiday Light Spectacular select nights in December. Come enjoy dazzling light displays, live entertainment, and pictures with Santa. Tickets and information available at the door or online at sarasotajunglegardens.com.
Check out My Suncoast Dining on MySuncoast.com, your guide to the foodie lifestyle. ABC 7's own Chef Judy serves up her favorite recipes, cooking tips and trends, dining blog, step-by-step videos, and Suncoast Restaurant Guide. You'll find it all at MySuncoast.com/dining.
On horrendously cold nights, on days when the rain has been relentless, or when the sun is beating down, there is an animal trapped with no protection, fighting to stay alive. Time is running out for them, but you can help save them by joining the ASPCA today. With your donation of just $18 a month, you'll help rescue abused and neglected animals, provide them with food, shelter, and medical care. When you go online or call in the next 10 minutes, we'll send you this free membership kit and our limited edition 150th anniversary t-shirt. It's just 60 cents a day to pull animals out of a terrible life. Don't let them suffer another day. Please help now.
The year is winding down, and that means big savings during the Big Finish event going on now at Sunset Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram in Sarasota. Ram trucks are built tough to help you conquer whatever the day may throw your way with all the comforts you'd expect in a luxury vehicle. And right now, all 2016 quad cabs are over 20% off, with new Ram trucks starting at just $19,999. Better prices, bigger selection. Go to Sunset Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram in Sarasota.
A poodle butter dish. I'll use this. A chicken purse. It's so artsy. You're really good at giving gifts.
This holiday, give the perfect gift.
Perfect.
Flowers, always the perfect gift. Boniva Flowers and Gifts, exceeding your expectations.
Don't miss Sarasota Jungle Gardens Holiday Light Spectacular select nights in December. There's joyous music, roasting marshmallows, and festive family activities. Tickets and information available at the door or online at sarasotajunglegardens.com. Oh,
Merry Christmas!
Well, Bob, it feels nice out there tonight. It feels like, I guess, how it should at this time
exactly.
of year.
Exactly.
Right?
Normal temperatures are expected tomorrow morning, mid-50s for the most part, upper 50s near the beaches. We had clear skies tonight and allowed us to see the International Space Station go on by just after 6 o'clock today. And we'll see another chance on Friday at 6:09. So there's another chance for it as it comes by on Friday. So if you didn't see it tonight, you'll be able to see it then. And skies should be clear that night, too. Right now, you can see this is a great shot that was sent in recently to our Pics at MySuncoast.com. Susanna sending that one in from the Venice Jetty. Some sunshine there. And as far as the overall picture goes in the satellite and radar imagery, not many clouds around here. There's some clouds down to our south, a few showers along the east coast and down through the Florida Straits, but all in all, fairly quiet here. What we have right now, basically, across the area is a stationary front that exists right across South Florida. This stationary front continues to bring some clouds and showers there, but not much going on here for us. We are a little bit cooler tonight. In fact, some cooler temperatures have moved in. We'll see low temperatures close to seasonal averages here. And as far as that fog forecast goes, current fog, not a problem at all. It was pretty quiet out there right now as far as clear skies go. 59 degrees, the humidity 90%, winds are out of the north-northeast at 5. The pressure continues to rise at this hour at 3022. And with the temperature and dew point still a little bit far apart, we're not seeing any fog form. The high today was below average at 1 degree, 71, And this morning's low is well above it at 64 degrees and no rainfall report. It's been dry and will stay that way too. It looks like right through the weekend, dry conditions anticipated as a result of a large area of high pressure, which will continue to dominate the weather over much of the eastern part of the nation. Now 41 degrees in Jacksonville. So that's the dew point temperatures. You can see those have continued to drop this evening. Still pretty high down to our south in Key West. And as far as actual temperatures go, pretty cool in places like Tallahassee and Jacksonville. 55 degrees now in Orlando, 71 the actual temperature now in Miami. Already down into the mid-50s in Arcadia, 57 degrees in Mayaca City, 57 degrees in Punta Gorda. Temperatures a little bit warmer right near the water, where the water temperature now is at 70 degrees. Forecast tomorrow looks a little bit better. More sunshine and a little bit warmer, too. It was pretty chilly today. High temperatures, we're not used to it. We're in the low 70s. Typically, we can see a high right around 72, 73. We'll be above that, 77 degrees. With, I think, more sunshine in the mix as that fog will still be around in some areas, but not a lot. And we're looking for that to burn off pretty quickly. Well, the storm track is now shifting out west. There's a big trough of low pressure that's going to develop here and then ridging off into the eastern United States. And what that usually means, the ridging brings fair skies, and the trough is where the low pressure systems start to develop. So you can see that already happening here in Southern California into Arizona. And there's another big storm system off into the Pacific, which will make its way on shore. Watches and warnings, well, they're out there, but not many in the eastern two-thirds of the nation. All of them are pretty much out west, where we have winter storm warnings in effect. Where you see the area in pink, the Sierra Nevada range, and winter weather advisories in effect. And it looks like this pattern is going to stick around, too, for a while out west. 32 in Buffalo, right at freezing right there. Same in Omaha, Wichita at 33, and Salt Lake City at 32 degrees. Dallas at 55, and they're actually warming up a little bit from what they saw earlier this week. 46 in Macon. For us, a little bit of cloudiness, a little bit of fog around. Much better, though, more sunshine. Front kind of dies out to the north of us on Friday, and we'll stick around with the warmer temperatures. Highs in the low 80s on Christmas Day. Patchy fog, north winds at 10 knots. Seas will be 2 feet with a light chop. But the water temperature at 70. It's still pretty warm for this time of year. Beaches will see a high near 76 degrees. Low tide upcoming, and then a high tide at 7:45. The forecast shapes up like this. For tonight, some fog late. And then we'll see mostly cloudy skies. And then tomorrow, morning fog burns off quicker, 77 for a high. The extended forecast calls for warmer temperatures, 80s right on in through this first full week of winter. Scott?
All right. Thank you, Bob. A measure that would expand where concealed weapons license holders can carry handguns in Florida may have an easier path through the Senate next year than in the past. Senate President Joe Negron sent the bill to three committees this week, two of which are led by prominent gun rights supporters. The bill would need to make it through those committees before it could be considered by the full Senate in March. The bill is sponsored by Suncoast State Senator Greg Stube and would allow people with concealed weapons licenses to openly carry handguns in public and on college campuses.
I've always been a strong proponent of the Second Amendment rights of law-abiding citizens. I think that a particular bill, we'll have to see what components are in that bill, but obviously I have a lot of confidence in Senator Stube.
During the 2016 session, open carry and campus carry measures failed to advance through the Senate Judiciary Committee. The family of the deceased The Voice contestant Christina Grimmie is suing the concert promoter and the foundation that owns the venue where she was killed. The singer was shot and killed in June during a fan meet and greet at the Plaza Live in Orlando. According to Billboard, the family has filed a wrongful death suit against promoter AEG Live and the Orlando Philharmonic Orchestra Plaza Foundation. The family is seeking the future income Grimmie would have made, as well as medical and funeral expenses. Florida's medical marijuana constitutional amendment goes into effect in less than 2 weeks, and the state's Department of Health has approved a seventh license for a grower. The department says it has reached an agreement with an indoor nursery in Lake Worth. The department also reached agreements with two nurseries as distributors. Amendment 2 takes effect January 3rd and allows higher strength marijuana to be used for a wider list of ailments once a new set of rules are implemented. The popular home sharing website Airbnb was a big moneymaker for Floridians this year. The website is a fast and easy way for people to rent out rooms or find vacation rentals while avoiding hotels. Airbnb says this year Floridians who rented out their homes to visitors earned $273 million collectively, with more than 1.5 million visitors. Here in the Suncoast, Sarasota County is contemplating joining a multi-county lawsuit over taxes and Airbnb. The company told the tax collector's office in Sarasota County that it would not provide the names and addresses of renters, although that information is required by state law. Stay with us. Sports is next.
An important message for Americans eligible for Medicare.
Are you receiving all the benefits available to you? Do you know there is money available to lower your Medicare prescription costs? Now's the time to find the coverage that's right for you at the right price. The way to do that is to explore your options. You can spend hours doing that yourself, or you can call Health Markets and let us do the legwork for you with no cost or obligation. We'll search a variety of plans from nationally recognized companies to find the coverage that's the best fit for you at a price that fits your budget, and we'll do it at no charge to you.
Plus, you may be able to save money on prescriptions. We'll tell you if you qualify. Why pay a penny more than you have to for an insurance policy?
Let us find you the right plan at the right price and see if you qualify to lower your prescription costs.
Put our free service to work for you at no charge.
Call the number on the screen now to make sure you're getting all the benefits you deserve. Don't wait. Call now.
Hi, I'm Chef Judy. Every Wednesday morning, I'll be with the chefs at the Publix Aprons Cooking School serving up the most wonderful dishes. Watch Aprons in the Kitchen every Wednesday on ABC7's Good Morning Suncoast.
Is your old garage door stuck or broken? Would a new one give you a lift? Let Precision Door Overhead Garage Door Service of Sarasota come to the rescue with prompt and affordable repair service. Replacement doors come with an array of styles and colors, and they are rated to meet and exceed Florida standards. From estimates to installation, your satisfaction is our priority. If you're not 100% satisfied with any product, service, or installation, we will make it right, because Precision Door Service is a name you can trust.
This holiday season, give the greatest gifts of all, safety and peace of mind. Subaru offers more 2016 IIHS Top Safety Pick Plus winners than any other brand. And Subaru has the best resale value of all brands for 2016. Now, during the Subaru Share the Love event, you can lease a new Forester for just $209 a month or get 0% financing. Get more for your money. Go to Sunset Subaru in Sarasota.
They took that stress and that tension when I was particularly feeling very bad after that nasty car accident, and it was such a relief to know that I didn't have to bear that burden alone, that I had help.
Our goal is to not just get a satisfactory settlement on their case, we want them up on their feet, happy again. They've gotten their life back.
Don't miss the 19th annual Thunder by the Bay Motorcycle Festival, January 5th through the 8th, to benefit Suncoast Charities for Children. This year's festival welcomes special guest Blue Oyster Cult to the premier sports campus at Lakewood Ranch on January 8th at 4 p.m. Admission is free. Festival events include a sporting clay tournament, kickoff party, welcome Thunder event, cruise for cash charity motorcycle ride, and a two-day rockin' and riding at the ranch festival featuring vendors, live music, a taste of Thunder area, and more. VIP tickets are available. For tickets and info, visit thunderbythebay.org.
Now, sports.
Florida Gators basketball team has played 11 games so far this season, and none of them were at home until tonight. At last, the renovated O'Connell Center ready for its debut as the Gators host Arkansas Little Rock this evening. It was a $64.5 million project, making the O-Dome one of the top arenas now in college hoops. During the renovation, head coach Mike White kept his team away from the O'Connell Center so that they could see the finished product. They did that earlier this week, seeing the new court, seating, and locker rooms. It got them fired up because they shot lights out tonight against Arkansas Little Rock. Devin Robinson scoring 21 points as the Gators win big, 94-71. Great matchup tonight in Louisville. 10th-ranked Cardinals taking on the 6th-ranked Kentucky Wildcats. Heisman Trophy winner Lamar Jackson, you saw him there at the game. First half, Wildcats up by a point. Louisville goes on a run. Deng Adel buries a three-pointer. It is an 8-0 Louisville run. Later, though, Kentucky goes on a run of its own as the Louisville crowd goes wild. Louisville would turn it over here, and then Kentucky gets ahead on the break. They get it out to De'Aaron Fox, and he'll slam it home. And that's a 9-0 Kentucky run. This was a close game until the very end when Louisville held on to beat the Wildcats tonight, 73 to 70. Starting Tampa Bay Lightning goalie Ben Bishop will miss the next 3 to 4 weeks after suffering a leg injury last night. Bishop was making a save when he went down and slowly, eventually skated off the ice. Tampa Bay beat the Red Wings 4-1 and will host St. Louis tomorrow night. Backup goalie Andre Vasilevsky will take his place in the lineup. Injuries really taking a toll on the Lightning so far this season. A short week for the Buccaneers. The team didn't arrive home from Dallas until 5:30 Monday morning after flight delays. Then it was back to work Tuesday, since most of the NFL games this holiday weekend take place on Saturday. The Bucs will finish out the regular season needing to win out for a chance at the playoffs, and they're playing two teams that will not make the postseason. But head coach Dirk Cutter expects to see the best from both the Saints this weekend and the Panthers in 2 weeks.
If you just look at our division, how it's stacked up right there, there's two division games left, so a lot could happen. And New Orleans and Carolina both coming off wins last week. In fact, we're the only team in our division that didn't get a win last week. So, yeah, we have no expectation of anything but a great game and super effort from both teams.
And the Bucs and Saints will play 4:25 on Saturday. The winning lotto numbers are next. We'll be right back.
I love big bling for little ching. That's why I only wear Spectralite diamonds from Created Gems, or I wear nothing at all.
The all-new MySuncoast.com. Just another way we're here for you.
Since 1972, Sleep King has provided quality mattresses and accessories at the best discounted prices available. Top brands like Simmons, Sealy, Serta, Beautyrest, iComfort, and more. With available free delivery, free financing, and free setup and removal. For a comfortable night's sleep with same-day delivery, even if we have to carry it on our backs. Trust Sleep King of Sarasota. Buy it today, sleep on it tonight.
Only Fiat gives you Italian engineering with a heavy dose of Suncoast style. So what are you waiting for? Hurry in for big savings during the Big Finish event going on now at Alfa Romeo Fiat of Sarasota.
Christmas traditions by LuxArts Silks, where more is merrier. Make your holidays sparkle with style. Browse our amazing showroom, cute collectible cottages, and beautiful Christmas displays. Find the inspiration, selection, and quality you need to deck the halls merry and bright. Christmas traditions also features the area's largest selection of quality pre-lit Christmas trees, every size, shape, and color, and plenty of decorations to make your home shine for the holidays. Christmas traditions by LuxArts Silks, where more is merrier. Visit us on New 301, just a quarter mile north of University Parkway.
Today, everyone is looking for more fashionable choices in flooring than ever before. And G. Fried has responded with a huge selection of carpets, tile, wood, laminate, and vinyl. Installed by a highly skilled team, G. Fried has got everything you're looking for and more. The next time you think about quality flooring, think G. Fried Flooring America. G. Fried Flooring America. Our world is at your feet.
Selling your home? Insist on a 3D showcase tour from Gulf Shores Realty. Virtual tours are flat and boring and look more like a slideshow than a tour. A 3D tour from Gulf Shores Realty is like actually walking through the home without the drive. Get instant access to your next home from any device. Multiple views give homebuyers a perspective like no other. For a limited time, mention ABC7 and Gulf Shores Realty will provide a complimentary 3D tour with your new listing.
Mirror, mirror on the wall, who's the blingiest of them all? You are. With Spectralite diamonds, all gorgeous and affordable. Only found at Created Gems, where you always get big bling for little ching.
Well, a Suncoast woman went into a local McDonald's for a Big Mac and left with a newborn baby. An employee of the McDonald's on U.S. 41 near Stickney Point Road in Sarasota says a woman had the baby in the restaurant's bathroom on Saturday. She was still about a month away from her due date. There was also a nurse from Sarasota Memorial Hospital eating at the restaurant at the time and was able to help with the delivery. As of now, the baby is healthy. His parents have named him Parker. We were speculating it could have been Ronald.
Or Mac.
Yeah, that too. Have a good night, everyone.